Hello everyone and welcome to another violin tutorial video of mine. Today we'll be doing a rudimentals these days on the violin. As always, today's tutorial is going to be completely beginner friendly, and of course I'll also go through an advanced version of the instrumental solo if you would like to play it that way. If you haven't already picked up the violin and would like to learn how to play the violin, I've actually created a Udemy course as well as a Skillshare course. They're totally identical. I've linked them in the description below. Now without further ado, let's get started. So the first verse sounds something like this. Sounds pretty simple, doesn't it? So how you play it is that you actually start in the first position, first finger on a D string. So 1, 0, and then you go to the third finger on the G string. So far you have 1, 0, 3, 3, 3, 3. So all right. The next part you'll do 1, 0, and then 3, 4, 4, 1. So it's. And then you go on the D string 1, 3, 4, 3, 3, 1. So it's. So 1, 3, 4, 4, 3, 3, 1. And then of course you have 0 on the D string, which means open string, and then 3 on the G string, and then 4, 3, 3 on the G string. Alright, and then you repeat the entire thing all over again. After you've done that, there's this last part that goes like. So that one is basically the same as the later half of the first portion. So it's on the D string, it is 1, 3, 4, 4, 3, 3, 1, and then 0, and then third finger on the G string, 3, 4, 3, 3. Okay, the next part is sort of the chorus or the pre-chorus, depending on which way you see it. Well, basically it's the part before the instrumental solo. So how it sounds like is something like this. So as you could hear from that section just now, it's basically two identical phrases repeated one after the other. So how you start it is starting on the A string, you have 0, 0, 2, 2, 0. So. And then you place the third finger on a D string. And then back to the A string on the third finger. 3, 3, 2, 4, 3, 2. So. And then you want to go up to the E string on the first finger and play 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 0. And then back to the A string, 3, 2. And then these days is 3, 2, 3, 2 on the A string. And then you repeat the entire of this section over again. Right? Then after that, you have your characteristic instrumental solo part. So the solo part is actually played something like this. You kind of have to slide your finger up to the starting note. So And then of course you repeat that section over again. So how you play it is something like this. So you start on the A string with a fourth finger, and you want your fourth finger to start somewhere below the E flat note, so you just kind of slide it up, and then you reach this E flat note here. Then you place your third finger a semitone below, which means flush with the fourth finger. 3, 2, 0, 0, and then you cross over to the D string with the third finger, and then 1, 0, and then 3 on the G string. And take note that the first finger on the D string is actually an E flat. I mean, you could play an E, there's nothing wrong with playing it like this, but I don't know, I prefer to play it using E flat instead, but it's up to you, right? So then after that, you go back to the A string with the second finger on the A string, 2, 0, 0, and a 3 on the D string, followed by your 1, 0, and a 3 on the G string. So, then you go back to the A string and do the entire thing over again. So it's, and then again, these days is actually on the G string, 4-3, 4-3. So for those of you who want to do the more advanced version of the instrumental solo, you can actually follow this tutorial from here on. It's one octave higher than the one that we covered earlier on, and it sounds something like this. So how you want to do it is something like this. You actually slide your fourth finger on the E string up to this E flat note up here. It is somewhere like the fourth position in May. If you're into positions, it's around the fourth position, fourth finger. But anyway, you're supposed to kind of slide it up and find the note. So it's around here anyway. 4. And then just go one semitone down using the same fourth finger, 4 again, but on D, and then 3, 1, 1 on the third position on the E string, and then you shift back down to the first position, and so 2, 0, then third finger on the A string, and then second finger on the A string, and then go back up to the third position, you're gonna play your C note, and 3, 1, 1, and then shift down again to the first position and play 2, 0, and then A string, 3, 2. And then of course you do the whole thing again. And then your final these days will be 3, 2, 3, 2 on the A string. And that's pretty much all there is to it. The second verse is almost identical to the first verse, and the bridge is not so much of a melody at all. So that's all we have for the song. Hope you enjoyed this video, and please leave a comment below to tell me what other songs you'd like to see covered on this channel. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.